University of Moradu. He earned the Master's of Engineering degree in 1999 and the PhD in 2003, both in Advanced Control Systems from Saga National University in Japan. From 2003 to 2004, he was a postdoctoral research fellow at the Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology, engaged in the Stanford University Research Collaboration on developing robot systems based on human skill primitives. He has won research grants from National Science Foundation, Department of Wildlife Conservation, Senate Research Committee, and National Research Council, and has published 7 index journal papers and 45 preferred international conference papers. He has been awarded the Outstanding Researcher Award of the University of Moradu for many years. He has published one book titled Classical Control Systems, Design and Implementation, and 3 other book chapters. He is one of the pioneers of the International Conference on Information and Automation for Sustainability and chaired the same session in 2006. Currently, he is the director of the Engineering Research Unit of Faculty of Engineering while serving in the Board of Studies, Faculty Academic Committee and Senate Research Committee of University of Moradu. Professor Munasingha is an amateur astronomer, a wildlife enthusiast and a nature photographer. He loves observing the night sky using telescopes and engages in wildlife adventures and bird photography. He provides his consultation to a number of government institutions, including the Arthur Sinclair Center for Modern Technologies, National Engineering Research and Development Center, Sri Lanka Planetarium, and National Science Foundation. Professor Munasingha has delivered keynote speeches at Sri Lanka Institute of Information Technology Research Symposium, Site of Research Conference, IIT Research Conference, Annual Symposium of Sri Lanka Institute of Artificial Intelligence, and International Conference of TOCH Institute in Kerala, India. Sir, let me have the honor of inviting you to chair this session.
Thank you very much for the nice introduction. As the chair of this session, I welcome all of you warmly for the session. And in this session on transport and traffic engineering, we have 4 papers to be presented. So let me get to the first presentation of the session. The title of the presentation is Enhancement of Hardness of Aluminium 6063 T6 Alloy by Applying Two-Step Edge Hardening Process. This research is presented today by Mr. R.V.S.K. Ranasimha, who is a researcher assistant in nanoferrous alloys. Let me invite Mr. Ranasimha to present his research.
Of this percentage, 0.6% alloys, there are two problems in commercially. One is the production cannot meet the demand because higher production time and relatively higher cost than other materials, wood, plastic, like that. So our purpose is reduce the production time and energy consumption in the part of process, the engineering process. This is the paste driver, aluminium and magnesium side. In aging process going on, this dark area below the 0.2 of silicon. Here, first grainy structure you can see that this is a part of laser diagram. There are point F, you can see this grainy structure. There are grainy structure combined with two phase diagram, one is alpha, other one is beta. Alpha is the solid solution of aluminium and magnesium silicide. Beta is the phase diagram of complete magnesium silicide. This is in a room temperature. When we are heat up to 540 degrees per 3 hours, totally convert into alpha phase as point M in phase diagram. Then we are doing edge hardening process. It's again heat up to 205 degrees of Celsius, keeping some soaking time, 1.5 hours. Again, magnesium silicide appeared as a precipitate, like the final diagram. So it acts as a barrier for dislocation movement. Therefore, strength and hardness will increase in the aluminium structure. This is the commercial, local industries commercially using aging from oil. They are first one is solution treatment. They heat up into 540 degrees for 3 hours. Then quenching, air quenching. Then again structure is struck as the alpha phase. Then again heat up to 205 degrees and do the aging profile. This one is the aging profile. But we proposed two-step aging profiles. Compared to single-step aging profile and two-step aging profiles, you can see you can improve the amount of precipitate. Amount of precipitate also increased and precipitate size distribution also can improve. So therefore, strength and hardness will improve the keeping saving time and saving energy. Our proposed two-step aging profile has a four parameters, temperature 1 and temperature 2, time 1 and time 2.